Hello again. This week I've been thinking again about digitisation. It's hard not to. There's so much going on. Well, I don't know if you know, but the joint meeting, which is the short name of the group of experts on rail, road and inland waterway transport that meets twice a year in Europe to make sure that RID, ADR, ADN are harmonised where they need to be. The joint meeting has had an informal working group on telematics in place for some years now. They are looking at the use of telematics and the electronic transmission of information by various parties through the dangerous goods supply chain. I can't remember when it was off the top of my head that this working group was set up, but I do remember that the issue that they wanted to address was the lack of technical standards in electronic data communication. Now, since then, of course, things have moved on quite a long way. Despite that, the informal working group is still looking at stuff like identifying who the different participants in the chain are and who needs to know what. Meanwhile, industry is already doing it and doing it very nicely without those standards. Thank you very much. And regular readers of HCB may, hopefully, remember the report we did on EPCA's workshop in June of last year, which looked specifically at digitisation in the chemical supply chain and illustrated quite a few projects that are going on right now in the real world. And not only are they allowing information to be transmitted faster and more accurately, but they're also revealing inefficiencies in the supply chain and allowing those companies that are participating in those chains to grasp those inefficiencies and take them out of the network. That's all very good. One thing that meeting brought up, as I remember, was, of course, the concept of blockchain technology. And some people seem a bit scared of blockchain because it's, you know, it's a bit like voodoo, really. Nobody knows quite how it works. But then I still don't know how my VHS recorder works. So, you know, does it matter as long as it does work? Well, you've got to put your trust in it. And trust is a big hurdle in all of this. You know, who can see my information? What are they going to do with it? Most recently, I've started to see actual examples of projects involving blockchain in the chemical industry. They're coming, and they're coming at you pretty quick. So if you're still worried about blockchain, it might be time to just swallow those fears and learn to live with it, because I fear this is the future. Don't have nightmares. See you next week.